being a God chaser. And when you are a God chaser, you have the authority to chase out everything in this place that is not like God. The way I came to see, we set the singers of the church down. But the way I came, if you walked in church with a foul spirit, they took the mic from you and said, sit down, baby. Till you get delivered. Now we get an attitude and pack our stuff and leave the church because we don't want correction. You better receive some correction. So and so God says, what are you doing with your oil? This is what I came for. Because we wear on the men and women of God. Pray for me, pray for me, pray for me. There's nothing wrong with touching and agreeing, but sometimes you get in a place where you got to lay hands on your soul.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
My mother was sick. I couldn't even talk to nobody about it. That was my mother. And like this woman, I said, God, I serve you. I am your prophetess. How can my mother have cancer? You know what the Lord said to me? She doesn't if you speak it. And we spoke the word. She was supposed to be here with me, but the enemy got busy in our finances. But we spoke the word. And my mother was cancer-free in a matter of months. They said 24 months for chemotherapy. Said, no, you're not going through that. Not for 2 years. Devil is alive. My mother was done in less than a year. The only reason it took her that long is because she chose to have the chemo. But she was healed when the Lord said, speak the word. And I came to tell you, you got to examine what's in your house. Because God is getting ready to use what is in you to produce your oil. And when your oil is produced, you will walk up in here. And everything will look different. Oh, I wish I had some praise. Can I get just about 5 people? You're here.
Amen.
Listen, we're not going to take all day.
Amen.
I'm already over my time. But if you want to touch and agree, real quick, because I believe God is about to break some sickness in you.
Amen.
Where are my witnesses? Do we have any prayer warriors in the house?
Amen.
Can I be honest? I'm not talking about physical sickness. I'm talking about emotional sickness that has the enemy lying to you. We're coming in church and we're wearing masks. You see one face when I'm leading praise and worship, but if you see me throughout the week, I got an attitude, I'm depressed, I'm low, I'm sad. That is not how God intended for us to live. My Bible says, the joy of the Lord is my strength. You need a release from God. I'm talking about a spiritual release. See, this is about elevation. Some of you in here are struggling with your relationship. And the problem is not God. The problem is you need to submit to the authority of the Holy Ghost. What are you saying, prophet? You got to stop rehearsing that demonic message that is in your head. For some of you, you're still rehearsing what was said to you in childhood. Some of you are still rehearsing church hurt. We can't worship God without the truth. You can get up here and dance in the spirit, but when you sit down, what is the truth? And the truth is, God says, I want to break agreement with all demonic assignment. That doesn't mean I'm possessed.
Amen.
It means I want to take your pain and shift it to purpose. I want to take what is missing and I want to elevate it until you are fulfilled if I never do the thing you keep asking me to do. God says, will you serve me diligently? Take me into worship, please. Will you serve me? If I say no to that thing? The thing you want most. Maybe it was even prophesied. But if I change my mind, will you still run from me with the same vigor? God says, will you be vulnerable enough to admit that I'm angry?